Hi guys, my name is Meesha and welcome back to Garment Borders YouTube channel. If you are new here, then make sure you hit that subscribe button down below, give this video a thumbs up and hit that bell as well, because you want to be notified when I make a new video, don't you? Come on. So as you can tell by the title, we'll be doing I'll be just talking you through some of the products that I sell on the site. I'm just breaking it down a little bit so you can have some understanding before you purchase, and hopefully this video will be helpful. So without any further stalling, let's get into it, and I hope you enjoy the video. So I'm gonna start off with the classic fringe, that's what I like to call it, the fringe that everyone should have at least on one of their garments or something in their house somewhere. This fringe is everywhere, popular. This is why I call it the classic fringe. So the classic fringe I'm talking about, if you don't know already, is the bullion fringe. So what the bullion fringe looks like ropes on the end of the braid. They come in different sizes. They come in like a really thin version, a medium version. They can come really long, they can come really short. They've got extra thick versions. So they all come in different versions, colors, sizes, and things like that. I believe they come in so many variations because they're so popular and they could be used for a lot of things. You can use them for curtains, you can use them for sofas, you can use them for your garments, you can use them for towels. They're pretty, you can use them a lot basically. versatile is the word I'm looking for. They can be pretty versatile. So the type of fringes I sell on my site are these ones. So as you can see, they are pretty medium-sized. They're medium-sized in my opinion. I don't think they're too thick and I don't think they're too thin either. I think they're perfect size. So with this, I would put these on a t-shirt or a jumper, maybe even a towel or something. Anything I want really, I could put them on. Yeah. At the moment, I only sell these in black. And I sell them per meter, so I'll put the link in the description bar below if you like them. But yeah, these ones are nice and sturdy. Yeah, they make a lot of sense. The other bullion fringe that I sell are a thicker version. So as you can see, it's much thicker than the fringe beforehand. These are definitely more like ropes. You can see that, right? Hopefully it's not blurry. Definitely more like ropes. These come in different colors. Also, I would use these more for jumpers, like thicker jumpers or coats. Just because the fringe itself is thick, I would like to keep the balance of the thickness. So I would use these. These can come longer or shorter, and be used for curtains or sofas as well. So this is this one. When I use these thicker fringes, because they tend to, because they're so thick, I mean, when you cut them, they tend to unravel. So what I would suggest is, I'm trying to see different ways on how to stop it from unraveling. But because it's so thick, you can't really do too much. You can't really help it. So I would just suggest cut slower than you would normally with a normal fringe. Just take your time when you're cutting it, and hopefully it will kind of reduce the unraveling. Yeah, so that's my little tip. It kind of works for me, so that's what I would do. And then the other last fringe I have is the thinner fringe. So it looks like this. You can tell how thin it is, you can just see automatically the difference in comparison to the medium sized one and the thicker one. You can see the difference, you know. This color is in steel gray, and I have this in white, in rose gold, navy blue. I have it in normal gold. So yeah, these fringes are a bit thinner, a bit more flimsy than the other ones, where they're more stern and more solid. But these ones are good if you're using it for children's clothes, for like their t-shirts. These are good for adult t-shirts as well. Yeah, you can't really go wrong with these. These are also very classic. You just have a thin one, so they're not too heavy on your clothes. So when it comes to the Bullion Fringes, the prices vary. So these ones would be £1.50 per meter. The thicker ones would be £1.99, as they're on sale at the moment, so you can get them on sale, you know. And these ones are £2.99, I believe, but the link will be down below in the description box. Always on my site there are discounts or coupon codes, so you're always saving money on the site. Sometimes a coupon code even includes the sale items, so not to worry if it's $2.99, sounds a bit expensive. Normally there's like a 10% discount on the site anyways. When it comes to these fringes here, they're also on a bundle, so you check out the bundles. You can get 10 meters I believe for $15.99. I've got so much in my head I don't really remember all the prices, but just check out the bundles and see, and you can save yourself a bit of money when purchasing, really. So that's my conclusion with the Bullions. They come in different colors, like pink, gold, silver, black, like I said, white, rose gold. So it's up to your preference and who you're buying it for. So yeah, just check out the link below to see all the Bullion Fringes and what's on sale and the bundles. And yeah, you can start shopping on garmentborders.com if you have to. we're here to help. So yeah, thank you for getting this far in the video. I hope this was informative. Don't forget to subscribe and hit the thumbs up button if you enjoyed this, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye.